Hello everybody, I've been doing a lot of work on tribal tension this week. Some of you might have seen my ongoing live streams. I've been testing out some cool new stuff for that game, and I had been working on a tutorial video this week on a sine wave shader, but unfortunately I've got to rethink some things about exactly where I'm going with that code, because I don't think what I had is really tutorial ready, unfortunately. So I've kind of had to put that on hold. I still wanted to do a video this week, so I'm bringing you a quick tip, something that was kind of covered in recent platformer video, but will hopefully be useful to some of you anyway. So today's quick tip is about importing sprites. Most of you already know how to import sprites by creating a sprite, hitting import and selecting an image. You can bring that image in. Oh, but wait, this image isn't formatted correctly. It's not individual frames. It's a bunch of images all next to each other, all spaced out. But we all already know that we can deal with that as well by going to Edit Image, Image, and Import Strip Image under here by selecting the thing. We can then split it into, we can define how our image is set up. And you can see these boxes appearing around the sprite. Hit Convert and bring it in that way. So, you know, there's no problem. You wouldn't really need to learn anything more than that. That's enough for you to be able to basically handle all your different kinds of artwork. But there is one more way of importing sprites that a lot of people didn't know about, and I didn't know about, and has existed since GameMaker 8.1. Was actually in the documentation for GameMaker Studio. I couldn't find it anywhere for GMS2, but it exists, and I never knew about it, so maybe you didn't know about it. What that is GameMaker actually checks when you import a sprite to see whether or not it has the word strip on the end of it here. You see the one I imported initially, S player, when I bring this in just brings us this, but this image next to it, which is exactly the same and just has strip 10 on the end. In fact, let's rename this one to demonstrate how it works. We know there are exactly 10 images in the sprite, so by writing strip on the end, that tells GameMaker that this is a strip image, like it's a sequence of sprites, and by putting a number on the end of that, 10, it tells us exactly how many images to split that up into. So now if I import this after renaming it, boom, it magically splits it into the 10 frames of our animation. And let's just demonstrate that working again. If I rename this to say strip 5, this will look ridiculous, but it'll demonstrate the point, and then import that, it splits it into 5. So we get a weird, crazy double running thing going on. But yeah, that's just another cool, fun way to import your sprites. It's existed for a long time. I never knew about it, but I know about it now. So if you knew about this already, then great. And if you didn't already know about it, then great, because now you know. Hope you enjoyed that, guys. Thanks for watching. Sorry there was no long form tutorial this week, but next week we'll be carrying on with the platformer stuff. That'll be part 3 of that series. Next Friday, and the week after that I'm going to be polling my $5 Patreon supporters, and I'll be doing that basically every other week to decide a new topic for each video. As I said, I've been working on a sine wave shader thing, but I wasn't really confident the code was consistent or is going to be useful to everyone, and it just needs more work, really. So sorry I couldn't bring that to you this week. I want to give a quick shout out to the following: In a Mule, Giles Montgomery, Dan, Angel Rodriguez, Harold Guidry, Roxom, Jason McMillan, and Owen Morgan for their continued support, along with the continued support of all my other Patreon supporters. Thank you guys very much for allowing me to keep doing this work, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, guys.